Morning guys, how you going? Look what I got. Check it out. Poor little dryer. Isn't it a sad sight? Oh man, this poor thing. Gotta feel sorry for it, right? Wow. I was at the dump 2 days ago. And I was dumping some green waste and I looked over at the steel. And I could see this bad boy propped up on an equally sad barbecue, actually. And, man, poor thing. So I came over, I went over and I had a look at him. And I just felt sorry for him. I mean, I don't even know what it is. It's either an Electrolux, Simpson, or a Westinghouse. Oh, in fact, hang on a second. Oh, there we go. It's got a sticker. It's an Electrolux. Wow. So check out inside. It's equally as sad. Look at that. I've never seen this before. This is the belt. That's the belt mark. Can you see the belt mark's actually rubbed through the stainless steel? That's crazy. Watch this. You can see it's all the way through and the stainless steel has gone all white and corroded and man, it must have like some kind of lining, I'd say, on the inside, and it's just, I've never seen anything out of the thousands of dryers that I've actually, well, at least 1,000 dryers that I've messed around with, but oh, that's dead. And look at this, the inner shroud, it's all going brittle and flaking off. Look at that, that's broken. That'll kind of tear your clothes up, and it's missing, the filter. That poor thing. And the door's a little bit sad. It's missing its cover at the bottom there, and the computer is gone. So I don't know. So whenever I see a dryer like this that's missing the computer, I always think that they've just, you know, pulled it off and they're dumping the rest, because the computer's the valuable thing, part of a dryer. In fact, you know, when I spun this just now, you see that? The belt's not even attached. In fact, let's actually have a look at the back. Let's see if he's tried to fix it. Ah, look at this. All the screws around the perimeter, well, most of them, are gone. They're missing. And around this cover at the back, this metal cover here, it's gone. They're gone as well. So maybe he... Ah, there we go. See, look, the power cord's gone. So what I think has happened, and the hook here that the power cord goes over, that's missing, that's broken. I think what's happened is he's decided to toss it and he's probably pillaged it. He's pulled all the good parts out and he's dumped it. But to me, this actual cover here, the you know, the outer shell, that's one of the best parts. That is the best part. That's the hardest part to get. That's in good condition. Oh, the switch, the door switch. He left the door switch. And this actually works really nicely. It's not difficult to push. Wow, he's got potential though. He's definitely got potential. So what do you think? What should we do with him? I don't know. We could rebuild it. You know what we should do? We should go all Steve Austin on its ass. We should build ourselves a $6 million dryer. I mean, we've got the technology. We've got the parts. We could make it better. Stronger. Faster. We'll give it a new capacitor. That'll make it go better. Yes, that's what we should do. We should build a $6 million Electrolux dryer. I'm pretty sure I have a bowl. That's a 6 kilogram bowl. I'm fairly sure. I've got a selection of them lying around. And I do have a bunch of inner shrouds. So that's a good thing. Guaranteed the motor's missing in this, but it doesn't matter. I'd probably put another motor on there anyway. Give it a new belt, another capacitor, idler, and a new computer. So that's the plan. That's what we're going to do. We are going to build the $6 million dryer. See what it looks like in the end. And we might even polish it up with a bit of car polish at the end. What do you think? finish it off. We'll see. There we go, guys. That's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to set up. We'll try and do this very quickly. I think we're going to get some rain today. But hold tight. I'll be right back. All right. So this is a plan. This is a plan. This is our sad-looking Electrolux dryer. We are going to pull out that awful-looking bowl. We're going to pitch that. We're going to toss this out as well. The inner shroud, everything's attached to that, the motor, the idler, the capacitor, we'll toss all of that stuff. I'd say if the motor was in there, I'd probably hold on to, I'm not going to hold on to the motor because this looks like it's been flogged. So the motor's probably shit anyway, so I'm just going to get rid of that. And we are going to put these new parts in. We got ourselves a really nice looking, virtually new looking Electrolux bowl. No marks at all. I'm just going to wipe that down with a damp cloth. It's in excellent condition. And we have this. This is the inner shroud and the motor's still attached. And it's even got, this is a brand new inner shroud, but you can tell because it's got a brand new, one of these new steel capacitors. And honestly, I've never seen one of these things die ever. So that's a good thing. Everything about this shroud is great because it's new. The plastic's great. It's in awesome condition. Oh, look. It's even got its filter still in there. Yep, and that's for an Electrolux. Yeah, and the cool part is the power lead, it's still attached. So that's what we're gonna do, folks. So pull up your pants, readjust that belt, and get ready. This is gonna be a fun one. Listen, the other thing is, I'm not gonna be walking you through this. I'm just gonna set you up to a time lapse. I have heaps of videos. If you ever want to see how anything's replaced or fixed, I've got heaps of videos in my playlist. Go and have a look at one of those. But for this one, this is just meant to be a bit of fun. All right, let's do it. Never found one of those in the dryer before. All right, well, check this out. As I expected, the heater's gone. So the heater element's gone. You can see they've taken the bearing out. So pull this off. Actually, this back is really nice. It's in good condition. We might use that. Put that there. Okay, so let's pull this out. This is going to the dump. And look, they've even pulled the fan out. I was hoping the fan was going to be in there because I can use that. But wow. Oh well, this is all of this stuff here is going to the dump. I'll probably keep the door and the door switch, and I will pull that wiring harness off because that'll come in handy. Oh, in fact, here we go, look. So the power cord is still in here, so I'll hold on to that as well for any future fixes. But as for most of that stuff, that's all going. At least it's in clean condition. I was expecting it to be very incredibly dirty, but I'll just give that a wipe down, make it look nice. It's there you go. So let's get back into this and make us a new dryer. We have the technology. All right, sorry guys. I actually forgot to record me taking this door off. It's only two screws and it's only a few screws for this inner shroud. So I'm not gonna redo that part of the video, but what I am gonna do is I've pulled off this wiring harness. I'll keep that. We'll keep this power cable, this shroud, we will dump, the motor's gone, so you kind of have to admire him. At least he's dumped something and he's pulled all the good parts off it first, so he's into recycling or making a buck. So good on him. So let's throw that out. And we don't need that. Right, I'm just going to blow this out, give ourselves a nice new canvas to work on. In fact, before we start that, I am going to just check that, I'm going to pull this motor off, just check that the fan is okay, because there's nothing worse than putting these things together and discovering the fan's a bit loose, so I'll check that out first. Oh wow, look at that. Man, this must be brand new, this machine. I've never seen a fan that's clear before. That's so cool. Awesome.
Thank you.
Here it comes. I've got to pack up. Well, it's about to start pouring. Sorry, I've had to pack up. I'll get back to this once the rain stops, but it's looking pretty good. It's looking really nice. But for now, I just got to clean this space up before everything gets wet. Okay, so it stopped raining. So let's finish this thing. Now, I think it needs a face. It's looking a bit, it needs some personality, don't you think? So let's a control pad on there, control panel interface. I just call them interfaces. Now have a look down here. This is what they look like. Now I want to show you something which is quite relevant, because we're making a better one. Remember, we're making a better, stronger dryer. So what would be the difference between these two, you think? Well, this particular one here, this particular interface here, let's have a look at the computer. Look at the computer on there. Okay, so remember this. Have a look at this transformer, this yellow little block thing. It's a transformer. It's tiny. And that is the computer that, if you were to buy one on eBay or one of the online websites, that is the computer that you will get. Now, let me put that aside. Let's have a look at this one. This particular one here, this interface, is probably 2 or 3 years older. And check this out. Let me flip it and show you the computer on this. Look at the chunky transformer. It is massive. Now, I'll tell you something. The computers out of these older Electrolux dryers, I have never, ever seen die. I've never seen a bad one. I've never had to replace one, and I've had to replace maybe 200 to 300 Electrolux computers. Easily, maybe more. And the ones that have this particular chunky transformer, man, they're awesome. They're indestructible. So that's what we're going to use on our dryer. And mine, by the way, you can actually use either this one or that one. Everything will work perfectly. No worries at all. I don't know why they changed to this piddly licking frickin' tiny thing. I'd say it's got something to do with built-in obsolescence. But yeah, we're going to put this one in, because remember, this is going to be a stronger dryer than it was before. So let's stick this interface and computer on and clean it up.
throttle. Check your brakes, man. We have separation. Inboard and outboard, they're on. We're coming forward with the side stick. I've got a blowout. Number three. Pitch your pitch to zero. Pitch is out. I can't hold out the two. Direction alpha.
He lost an arm, two legs, and one eye, but he's alive. I'm not sure he'd want to live if he can't be the man he was. What if he could be more than the man he was?
Better.
Stronger. Faster.
Steve Austin, astronaut. A man barely alive.
Gentlemen, we can rebuild him. We have the technology. We have the capability to make the world's first bionic man.
Right, now he's looking a bit better. Sorry, he's on an angle. We're on a driveway and my driveway is very steep. And I'm using a gimbal, so it's always level. But there you go, doesn't he look heaps better? Awesome. Inside. Bowl looks good. You may have just noticed I just swapped the door over. Now this door, I scrubbed it up, it looked really nice. But then I noticed, I don't know if you can see that on the camera. I don't think you can, but it's got, just there. It's got a few tiny little kind of stress fractures. It's nothing, it's really nothing. People go crazy about those things, but it's still a good door, but because we're building a really good dryer, a better dryer, I thought I'd put an almost new door on, and that looks so much better. Well, there you go. What do you think? He looks fantastic. He has his dignity back. So there you go. Listen, I was going to polish him up with some car polish, but I thought against that. I've actually cleaned him up with some wet and dry, got all those marks off, so that'll do. He's pretty shiny anyway, like with the new door and the interface and the new bowl inside. He looks like he's almost new, to be honest with you. So what I'm going to do now is, I'll just set you back here. I'm going to go behind there, plug him in, and then I'm going to turn him on, see if he turns on for a start. All right, let's plug him in now. All right, it's plugged in. Obviously the power switch isn't turned on, so let's do that. Yes! All right, we have a success. Now let's hit play and see if it works. Excellent, there you go. Doesn't get any better than that. He sounds great. Seriously, whoever gets this dryer is going to be one very lucky person, I reckon. But there you go. I know this video was a bit stupid with all that Steve Austin stuff, $6 million man, but hey, I loved him as a kid, even though I don't think I was born when the TV show came out, but I still watched all the reruns. But anyway, there you go. Anyway, thanks for watching, appreciate it. Please like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one. Thank you.